Once upon a time, in the long ago, when there were so many wild animals prowling about that nobody was surprised to meet a wolf or a bear at any moment, there lived a little girl called Red Riding Hood. Everybody called her that because she always wore a red cloak and hood which her kind old grandmother had given her. One day, after Red Riding Hood had been a very good child, her mother said to her, "Today you shall have a holiday, my dear, and visit your grandmother. See, I have placed in this basket a pot of honey and a pat of butter and two fresh eggs for tea. Carry them carefully and do not loiter on the way." Red Riding Hood promised, and off she went. At first, she carried the basket most carefully, but when she got into the wood, she longed to put the basket down and pick the flowers. Just then, a great wolf came along and stopped to speak to her. "Good morning," he said, "and where are you going this fine day?" "Good morning, Mr. Wolf," said Red Riding Hood, dropping a curtsy. "I am going to see my grandmother." "Where does your grandmother live?" said the wolf. "She lives all alone in a little cottage covered with roses," said Red Riding Hood. "But how do you get in?" said the wolf. "Oh, I just tap at the door, and grandmother says, 'Lift the latch and come in.'" "Then," said the wolf, "why don't you gather some flowers for your grandmother?" Now Red Riding Hood thought this a very good idea, and began to gather flowers, and quite forgot that she had promised not to loiter. Meantime, the wicked old wolf went away to find the cottage, and remembered to tap at the door. "Lift up the latch and come in," cried the grandmother. The wolf lifted the latch, the door flew open, and in he rushed and swallowed the poor old grandmother in one mouthful. Then he tied on one of her nightcaps and jumped into bed. By this time, Red Riding Hood reached the cottage and tapped at the door. "Lift up the latch and come in," said the wolf in his best voice, but that was not a pleasant one. Now Red Riding Hood walked in very frightened. "But grandmother, how strange your voice sounds, and why are you in bed?" she said. "Oh, I have a cold on my chest," said the wolf, "but come in and sit on my bed, my dear." Red Riding Hood obeyed, trembling. "Grandmother, grandmother, what great eyes you have!" "All the better to see you with, my dear." "But grandmother, what great ears you've got!" "All the better to hear you with, my dear." "But grandmother, 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 what great teeth you've got!" "All the better to eat you with, my dear," said the wolf, as he sprang at little Red Riding Hood. He ran screaming to the door, and in rushed the woodcutter, who happened to be her own father, and with his big axe, he killed the wolf. "Oh, I think he has eaten up my poor dear grandmother," said Red Riding Hood. "We shall soon see," said her father, and he cut the wolf open, and there they found the dear grandmother, all safe and sound, for the wolf had swallowed her so quickly, his teeth did not hurt her. And they had a happy reunion. And you may believe that little Red Riding Hood promised never, never, never to loiter when sent on an errand again.